Hey Sabina, Ian here with analysis of the two videos that you just sent me of your forehand. Overall, really happy with what I'm seeing here. You're executing the footwork patterns overall really nicely, and more importantly, you're maintaining really high quality of execution with your swing technique as well. I want to be really clear that it's completely normal that your execution dropped. It should drop anytime challenge or stress is added to the environment, then whatever the new thing is, execution will 100% drop and you will fall back more on your old habit. So don't be frustrated by that. Don't be upset about that. That's what should happen. And so this is the process, is adding one layer of challenge, starting as easy as humanly possible, making sure that we're really clear on what we're doing, and then slowly adding one layer of challenge at a time while building back up ability to execute the new thing. And so you're doing a really nice job. One thing on the open stance I want to point out, basically on both the open stance and the closed stance, there's kind of one little pattern creeping in that is a little bit extra. And we want to try to clean those up as we go. And what's happening here is you're starting off with a shuffle a lot of times, or even a couple different shuffles. So here is your split step right here. And then you're starting by actually lifting your left leg, your left foot off the court, and pointing your right foot forward. So this is what we should see. This is what should really initiate your movement. And then from here, your left foot should cross over, and you should basically just be in a lateral walk across the baseline at that point, or run, depending on how far away the ball is. But occasionally, you get caught in kind of this shuffle pattern. And what's happening here is you're trying to judge exactly how far away the ball is, or it's just a bad habit. Either way, this is not getting you to the ball as quickly or efficiently as you could be getting there. And so when you watch Kevin's demonstration of this footwork pattern, you'll see that he initiates with this right foot pointing out along the baseline. And then his very next step is his left foot coming across his right foot to stride along the baseline. And then from there, he continues to stride along the baseline until he gets to where the ball is. This could just simply be you trying to measure how far away the ball is and figure out exactly how much space you have to cover in order to actually get to the ball. Or it could be you kind of trying to set up your feet in a particular pattern that you're most comfortable with. But either way, we want to try to erase that and start striding across the baseline as early as possible without throwing in those early shuffles, which are they're basically just wasting time. And they're keeping you from getting to the ball a little bit earlier in order to hit a little bit more comfortable and effective shot. And so you kind of go in and out of that. You do not do this every time. This is just the one kind of specific pattern that I did see pop up here and there. And so you're kind of shuffling, and then getting into a stride across the baseline. Other times you do stride across the baseline, and it's usually the ones where you identify right away, like here, that you realize, oh man, I've got to really get on my horse to get to this ball. And so you're initiating with that right foot, which is great. And then right away, your left foot goes across. And so on any wide ball, that's the pattern that we want to see. And so we just need to be a little bit more mindful and disciplined about executing that a little bit more cleanly. If it's not very wide, then that little bit of a shuffle to where you're trying to get to is totally fine. On a wider ball, it's really kind of a waste of time, and you're not getting to the ball as efficiently as you could be. So that's the one thing there. Overall, your upper body technique execution is really good. Occasionally, you're a little short of parallel, but for a wide ball and this open stance footwork pattern, you're really doing excellent and really happy with your execution overall. Okay, over to the square stance one. By the way, I totally agree with your decision. And I was actually surprised. I went back and checked my action plan, because I was actually surprised that I didn't ask you to have the ball machine feet a little bit shorter. I think I was just trying to keep it a little bit more simple, so you didn't have as many variables and you could just kind of go right to the next drill. But I totally agree with your judgment call here to feed the ball a little bit shorter on the square stance hit. That absolutely is the situation where you're gonna more want to use this footwork pattern as opposed to the open stance. And so I think this is ideal practice. So nice job on that. The little bit of extra stuff that's creeping in here in your patterns is again kind of a little bit of a shuffle. When you watch Kevin execute this in the drill video that I sent you, you'll see him again initiate with his right foot pointing out, and then his left foot goes across, and then he immediately starts closing forwards to transfer into the ball. And you're adding a little bit of a little kind of gallop shuffle here in between, right here. And I'd much rather see you step across with your left foot so that you move across that section of court more quickly and more efficiently. That little bit of a kind of gallop shuffle is, again, I think just you trying to measure the ball and measure your spacing a little bit better. But I'd really like you to try to clean that up and cut that out so that there's not extra time being used in order to get to the ball efficiently. Not the end of the world at all, but since we're using a ball machine and you're getting very similar feeds over and over, I'd really like to see you try to be disciplined to execute exactly the steps that Kevin demonstrated in that demonstration video. So occasionally a little kind of hop shuffle here on the way to the ball. Other times you're really clean and just using the steps that you need to get there. Again, upper body execution overall is really, really solid. Occasionally, you seem to get a little bit close and a little bit jammed to the ball. You look a little bit restricted. This is totally fine. Occasionally, you look a little bit closer than that, and things look a little bit jammed. That's really the only thing that I'm seeing pop up here and there. But overall, your execution with your kinetic chain is really solid, and overall, your footwork patterns are really solid. Totally agree with your decision to take out targets for the time being until you get a little bit more comfortable and confident executing the patterns with your swing technique. The patterns with the swing technique with the targets is obviously kind of the ultimate goal that we're shooting for, but you're really smart to kind of take things one little step at a time and make sure the quality is good. So stay patient. And keep doing what you're doing overall. Hopefully, these couple of tips here help you execute a little bit more smoothly. Overall, things are looking really nice. Here's one that I can see you're a little bit close and jammed. It's really the only thing I saw pop up at all on both swings. So keep up the good work. Great job. Let me know if you have any questions.